Dear learners, Namaskar. I am Manju Trungu. Welcome you to the program of Library and Information Science at senior secondary level. In the last program, we discussed about the need, importance and functions of the library in the society. We also discussed that libraries play an important role in socio-economic, cultural and educational development of a society. The libraries strengthen literacy among the people. Library services improve knowledge and skill of people. There are many types of libraries in the world. The topic of our today's discussion is types of libraries and information centers. We shall discuss different types of libraries, their functions in the present day society. Let's begin with the types of libraries. There are different types of libraries. These can be categorized into four types: public, academic, special, national library. We shall discuss the public library first. Public library is a social institution. It plays a significant role in the welfare of a society. It's a non-profit library which is established for the use of general public and maintained chiefly by public funds. In other words, we can say that public library is for the public, by the public, and of the public. It provides services to every citizen without any cost, irrespective of birth, caste, color, sex, social and economic and educational standards. Libraries of all categories are generally used for five purposes: education, information, recreation, aesthetic appreciation, and research. Let's discuss about UNESCO's Public Library Manifesto. UNESCO formulated a Public Library Manifesto for member countries in 1949 and revised it in 1972 and 1994. UNESCO prepared the Public Library Manifesto in the Public Library Association and Institutions, that's IFLA, International Federation of Library Association and Institutions. This manifesto is widely accepted by all countries. It provides guidelines regarding objectives, activities, services, funding, legislation, networks, operations and management. Implementation of this manifesto for the public libraries. Mission for the public library. The key mission of public library are related to information, literacy, education and culture. These are created and strengthening reading habits in children from an early age, supporting both individual and self-conducted education as well as formal education at all levels, providing opportunities for personal creative development, stimulating the imagination and creativity of children and young people, promoting awareness of cultural heritage, appreciation of the arts, scientific achievements and innovations, providing access to cultural expression of all programming arts, fostering intercultural dialogue and favoring cultural diversity, ensuring access for citizens to all sorts of community information, providing advocate information services to local enterprises, associations and interest groups, facilitating the development of information and computer literacy skills and supporting and participating in literacy activities and programs for all groups and initiating such activities if necessary. Dr. S. R. Ranganathan has described objectives and functions of public libraries as, according to him, the objectives and functions of public library are to help the lifelong education, furnish up-to-date facts and information on all subjects, distribute in an unbiased and balanced way all recorded information to all citizens, which help them in discharging their duties, convey new knowledge to the researchers as early as possible, preserve the cultural heritage of the country, work for the continued social well-being of the citizens. The functions of the public libraries are like this. Most of the countries have legislation for the public library system. They are set up considering an organizational structure and geographical distribution to reach all the people, that is, all the states, districts and villages, in order to attract users to the library and to sustain their interest in readings. The library organizes cultural activities such as lectures, discussions, films, shows, material, concerts, plays, and art exhibitions, and story hours also for the children. It not only serves as a repository of the books, but as a cultural center also. A public library therefore plays a very important role in building well-informed, skilled and productive citizens. Examples of the public library are Delhi Public Library, which is in Delhi, Khuda Bakhsh Oriental Public Library, which is in Patna. Till now, we were talking about the public libraries. Now, we are coming to academic libraries. The role of the library in any academic institution can be realized only in the context of the institution's philosophy of education. This is true for most of the libraries of the world's academic institutions. Education is the process of learning with an aim to develop the capabilities among the people. Academic libraries, which comprise school, college, university libraries, have normally four types of users, which are based on the level of education they are supposed to cater to. These can be students, teachers, research scholars, administrative professionals, and other staffs of the institution. Their objectives, functions, and sources of finance, qualification, designations, and strength of staff, this all differs according to the types of library. Building up a collection of books, periodicals, reference books, and other multiple media materials constitute an integral part of the learning, teaching, and research. The services such as provision of reading facilities, lending, and reference services, etc., also differ in these libraries. The objective of academic library is to serve the needs of the academic community. Collect and store all the kinds of reading and reference material. Provide reading areas for users. Render lending services appropriate to the students, teachers, and researchers. Provide an active reference and information service. Academic libraries are grouped into three categories. These are school libraries, college libraries, university libraries. We can talk about the school libraries first. School libraries are further divided into four groups according to their level of education. Therefore, schools are primary, middle, secondary, senior secondary. Objective of school libraries: all types of school libraries have a primary with the following objectives. To awaken and foster the interest in reading books among children. To create love for books. Promote reading habits. To inculcate communication skills through extracurricular activities like storytelling, viewing and discussion on audiovisual programs and workshops, etc. Functions of the school libraries. In order to attract students to the library and develop their interest and curiosity, a school library should acquire a good stock of teaching, learning material for students and teachers. Display books in classified order. Provide functional physical facilities such as building, furniture, and equipment. Hire qualified, committed staff. Schools at primary level, secondary, senior secondary level require similar considerations: lending, reading, reference services, guidance, advisory services with the objective of inculcating interest of children for reading books and other reading materials. Example for school library are Delhi Public School Library in New Delhi, Kulachi Hansraj Model School. Any school can have a library. These are one among those schools. Now we coming to the college libraries. The support of library at the college level is essential to broaden the minds of the young students to meet new challenges compared to the school education. College education is totally different for students. There are a large number of students in each class, therefore it's not possible for the teachers to give the individual attention to each student. However, the students have to depend on college library for their studies and they develop a habit of learning, self-learning. College libraries are further classified into four categories, that is junior college, degree college, postgraduates and professional colleges. Objectives of college library are: chief objectives of college library are to give enrolled students a wider and deeper understanding of the various disciplines, to provide guidance to students for higher studies and self-learning, to prepare students for shouldering higher responsibilities in schools, government departments, civic organizations, commercial establishments, business and industrial companies, to train them to become an enlightened, knowledgeable and responsible citizens, and prepare them from varied professionals like law, medicine, engineering, technology, Functions of the college library can be: basic functions are to assist its parent body to carry out the requirement of its teachers, students regarding reading, study and research. Providing physical facilities such as functional building, furniture, equipment, etc. Provide latest editions and multiple copies of curriculum-based textbooks and recommended books for their study. Equip the library with a large range of reference books. Develop collection of latest books in different subjects and periodicals, including their back volumes also. To procure multiple media material and computer-aided teaching, learning and materials. To subscribe to important newspapers and other library materials such as popular fictions, biographies, travelogues, art books, etc. for the recreation purpose. To preserve various years' question papers to help their students. The services are provided by the college library are: reading, lending, textbook services, guide students in the use of manual or computerized catalog, assist in locating books, reference books from the shelves, train and instruct students to use library resources in an effective and efficient manner, provide information, reference and referral services to all library members, display new books, list of multiple media material, procure, advocate multiple media material and equipment to render them usable and reprographic services. Examples for the college libraries are Kirorimal College Library in Delhi, Lakshmibhai College Library in Delhi, Government College Library, Technology Library in Coimbatore. After discussing the college libraries, we are coming to university libraries. University libraries in India, a number of universities have grown ever since 1947. The growth is evident from the growing number of students, enrollment, research scholars, courses in varied disciplines and multi-disciplines, creation of a number of new departments, research projects and a large number of faculty members. There are different types of universities such as conventional, professional, deemed and open universities. A university library is established, administered and maintained to assist the university in five major functions such as teaching, learning, research, generation of new knowledge, dissemination and publication of research results, conservation of knowledge and ideas and extension programs. The university libraries have to play a very large challenge and difficult role to satisfy the demand of large group of students, research and postdoctoral research scholars, members of various academic and executive bodies of the management, administrative and professional staff of the university. Objectives of the university library. University library plays a very important role by supporting and helping the university in achieving its aim and objectives. It has to cope with the multidimensional activities of the university. The objectives of the university library are to provide intellectual, managerial leadership among the professionals in various fields of government, industry, health, engineering, law, medicine, defense, education, agriculture, and inculcate in them the sense of social purpose. To guide research workers in all areas so that result of research could be harnessed to improve the quality of life of the people and to conserve the knowledge and ideas for posterity. Functions of the university library. Main functions and major functions: to develop collection of print and media resources in a wide variety of subjects for learning, teaching, research, publications, etc. Organize and store the acquired collection knowledge for the use by the readers. Provide a variety of library documentation and information services, both responsive and anticipatory. Encourage students, researchers and teachers in groups the library for pleasure, using self-discovery, personal growth and sharpening of intellectual skills. Services of the university library. The nature and efficiency of services provided vary from library to library. With the introduction of information and communication technologies, ICT, most of the university libraries have automated their library operations using library management softwares and are providing a variety of services which were not provided before. University library provides services as mentioned. Reading and lending services, bibliographic instruction and library orientation, assistance in the use of library catalog and locating documents, reference and information services, current awareness services, that's CAS, selective dissemination of information, SDI, bibliographic services, interlibrary loan services, reprographic services, maintenance of newspaper clippings, maintenance of vertical files containing pamphlets, prospects, reports, and question papers from the various years of examinations, reservation of documents, user education, exhibition and special display, special lectures, demonstration of new software and services, user-oriented seminars, workshops. Example of university libraries can be, like we have Delhi University Library, Jawaharlal Nehru University Library, Madras University Library. These are some of the examples. Now we have come to special libraries. Special libraries came into existence in the 20th century. Special library deals with a special user group, has special subject collection, renders special services. These libraries are established to meet the organizations to which they are attached. They are generally devoted to research and development activities and procure all the types of documents in the form of handbooks, technical reports, state-of-the-art reports, bibliographies, current awareness bulletins, periodicals, indexes, abstracts, directories, documentation lists, and accession lists. Definition of a special library, Herald's Librarian's Glossary of Terms. How it defines a special library is, special library is a collection of books and other printed, graphic, or recorded material dealing with a limited field of knowledge and provided by learned society, research organizations, industrial or commercial undertakings, government departments, or even in the educational institutions. It may also be special branch of a public library serving certain interests or occupational groups, such as technical library or a special subject library, meeting the needs of all inquiries on all given subjects, such as music library. What are the objectives of the special library? Special library is an integral part of parent institution and fully supports its programs and activities. Main objective of the special library is to develop current as well as retrospective collection in core subjects based on the projects, programs of their parent organization. Their aim is to provide promptly the latest information about a significant development in the field wherever requested by the users. It provides all types of academic, technical, documentary support to render appreciate services to the specialists. Functions of the and the services of the special library are, it performs the various functions like provide services, performs exhaustive literature research to compile comprehensive lists, selects, procures, organizes, stores, and retrieves current information required by the users, analyzes, synthesizes, and evaluates available information, provides state-of-art reports, critical reviews, monographs, research reports, and reprints. It provides indexes, abstracts, extracts. It prepares accession lists, bulletins, newsletters, summaries, handbooks, manuals, and biographies. Issued documents, including interlibrary loan also. It renders reference and referral services, provided current awareness services, CAS, selective dissemination of services, SDI, and translation services. There are two types of special libraries. These are varied types of special libraries. They are government libraries, like Parliamentary Library in New Delhi, Secretariat Library, New Delhi, Libraries of Societies and Institutions, UP Historical Society, Lucknow, World Poetry Society, Intercontinental in Chennai, Industrial and Commercial Organizations, Library of Larsen & Toubro in Mumbai, Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited Library in New Delhi. From research organizations, Indian Council of Medical Research, New Delhi, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, New Delhi. Academic institutions is Indian Institute of Technology at New Delhi, Bombay, Chennai, Kanpur, School of Planning and Architecture in New Delhi, Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management, New Delhi. Public libraries. Special public libraries are New York Public Library in New York Science Division, Delhi Public Library, New Delhi. Examples of the special libraries, These were the types, and now I can say the example of the special libraries: IIPM Library, New Delhi; National Institute of Immunology, New Delhi. We come to national libraries. In most countries, there is a national library maintained by national resources, usually entrusted with the responsibility of publishing a national bibliography. National libraries collect and preserve the nation's literature. Most national libraries receive by legal right a copyright or deposit, one copy of each book and periodical printed in the country. A national library is a library specially established and funded by the government of a country to serve as the preeminent repository of information for that country. In national library, a limited number of books are lent out to readers under certain terms and conditions. It rarely allows citizens to borrow books, rare, valuables, significant works. Definition of the National Library is Herald's Librarian's Glossary in 1987 defines the National Library as a library maintained out of government funds and serves for reference only. This usually receives material through legal deposit legislations. The function of such a library is to collect and preserve for posterity all the published records, books, periodicals, newspapers, and other printed and multimedia material of the country's cultural heritage. This is best done by law requiring publishers to deposit copies of all publications produced by them and by purchasing books on their country published in the other countries. A legal deposit normally has penalty clauses to enable the act to be enforced. Objectives and functions of the National Library. The main objective of a National Library is to provide, identify, acquire, organize, store, and retrieve all print and non-print documents published within the national and the country in other countries also. The functions of the National Library recommended in the final report of the regional seminar on the development of National Library in Asia and Pacific area held in Manila in 1964 has given to provide leadership among the nation's libraries, to serve as a permanent depository for all publications issued in the country, to acquire other types of materials, to provide bibliographical services, to serve as a coordinating center for cooperative activities, to provide services to government. Examples of national libraries are: these are comprehensive national libraries of the countries performing all activities and functions. They are National Library of India. Web address is www.national.nationallibrary.gov.in. Library of Congress, LC USA. Web address is www.loc.gov/index-index.html. British Library, UK. www.bl.uk. National Library of Canada, www.owtawakiosk.com/national-library.html. These were the different types of libraries we have been discussing till now. Let's summarize what we have discussed in today's program. In today's program, we have introduced you to different types of libraries that fulfill the information needs of various people. We have discussed the objectives, functions, user groups, services rendered by each type of library, that is academic, special, public, and national library. As a whole, these libraries serve the purpose of varied users, from a general approach to a particular approach. Acquaintances with these libraries in their nature of collection, functions, and services shall be encouraged you to know more and more about these libraries at higher levels. Public libraries are social institutions that offer information dissemination services to various public groups. The collection is based on social, political, economic, and cultural subjects. Academic libraries serve the students, teachers, and research scholars. Special libraries serve specialists, researchers in special fields. National libraries cater to the entire nation, having all types of collection in all languages. There is no sharp distinction between types of libraries, whether it is management, engineering, medical, college libraries. They are academic as well as special libraries. Public libraries can make more positive attempt to develop collection for special groups of adult learners. I hope that you have understood the different types of libraries, their functions and objectives. Thank you.